The name axolotl is not English in origin, so when we pronounce it axolotl, that's technically not how it was said at first. Here's the original pronunciation of this word.
Axolotl.
Of course, this happens with the borrowing of words from different languages, so when folks say axolotl, most people know what animal they're talking about.
Axolotls are classified in the mole salamander genus. The genus name, Ambystoma, is believed to be misspelled with an L missing from the word. It may have been intended to be Amblystoma, which would mean blunt-mouthed.
Technically speaking, some other mole salamander species are sometimes referred to as axolotl as well. This is because in their juvenile stage, other mole salamanders have external gills like the axolotl. These salamanders, however, complete their life cycle and enter a terrestrial adult stage. Axolotls remain in their neotenic juvenile stage.
The name axolotl is Aztec in origin. It's often translated to mean water dog. However, another translation is water slave. This description is apt, as it clearly denotes the axolotl's continued juvenile body into what is essentially adulthood. Because of this, these vertebrates can't leave the water, so they are in essence slaves to the water.
Axolotls have regenerative capabilities that have been studied for hundreds of years. Not only can they regenerate their tail or a lost limb like other salamanders, axolotls can regrow their jaw and gills, as well as heart, eye, spinal cord, and brain tissue. Salamanders are the only known vertebrates with full limb regeneration ability.
Part of the reason axolotls may be such fantastic regeneration machines is because of their Peter Pan lifestyle. As other amphibians age, especially after they metamorphose into adults, they become less capable of limb regeneration. Axolotls, however, rarely undergo metamorphosis, so their youthful body may actually be a contributing factor as to why they're such masters at regrowing lost body parts.
While these salamanders can regenerate lost limbs, they can't defy death. Axolotls are critically endangered, so scientists have looked for ways to breed them successfully in captivity. In fact, axolotls are the first salamanders studied to survive artificial in vitro fertilization. In other cases, male salamanders had to be killed to obtain their gametes, but at least one study has suggested a way to retrieve these without the death of either parent.
Thankfully, wild axolotls are not typically caught and brought in for laboratory research. Axolotls used in scientific study almost all come from a stock that was originally procured from Mexico in 1863. These 34 axolotls were shipped to Paris, and their progeny have continued into modern times. The same can't be said of some other salamander species, such as tiger salamanders, who were often collected from the wild for research purposes.
There's an entire breeding facility dedicated to maintain axolotl populations in captivity for research purposes. It's called the Ambystoma Genetic Stock Center. It's located in Kentucky and houses thousands of axolotls from eggs to adults. These are for research purposes only, however, and the AGSC clearly states that it does not sell pets.
Axolotls are part of a conservation paradox. Wild individuals are critically endangered due to habitat loss to the point that the species may become extinct in the wild during the lifetime of those of you watching this video. At the same time, they are readily and easily available in captivity, although these stocks may suffer from a too similar genetic pool, which can make them susceptible to large-scale population death by disease.
You've also probably heard that axolotls are salamanders with external gills and never grow up. But if you weren't aware of these facts, you can learn all about them and more in our full axolotl episode. There's a card on screen you can click right now. Go ahead, click it. There's lots to learn. And thanks for watching Animal Fact Files.